وفي إطار زيارة الفريق الركن مع الشيخ راشد بن عبد الله آل خليفة وزير الداخلية إلى المملكة المتحدة وبدعوة من جمعية الصداقة البحرينية البريطانية، ألقى معالي وزير الداخلية كلمة أمام أعضاء الجمعية بحضور معالي الشيخ فواز بن محمد آل خليفة سفير مملكة البحرين لدى المملكة المتحدة.
وفي مستهل اللقاء ألقى السيد بيتر سينوك رئيس جمعية الصداقة البحرينية البريطانية كلمة ترحيبية عبر فيها عن شكره وتقديره لمعالي الوزير واعتزاز الجمعية بحضور معاليه حفلها السنوي، مشيدا في الوقت ذاته بالعلاقات التاريخية والمتميزة التي تجمع مملكة البحرين والمملكة المتحدة. كما تحدث السيد توبياس إلود وزير الدولة البريطاني لشؤون الشرق الأوسط، حيث استعرض العلاقات الوثيقة التي تربط البلدين الصديقين، مشيدا بتنامي حجم التبادل التجاري بينهما بما يعكس قوة ومتانة العلاقات الثنائية، الأمر الذي يمهد الطريق لأفاق من التعاون البناء في ضوء ما تتمتع به مملكة البحرين من مكانة متميزة لدى المملكة المتحدة. بعد ذلك ألقى معالي وزير الداخلية كلمته والتي أعرب فيها عن تقديره لجهود الجمعية وأعضائها والذين كانوا مثالا للأصدقاء الحقيقيين في جميع الظروف، مشيرا إلى ما تحقق في البحرين من انفتاح وتطوير ديمقراطي وسياسي أرسى دعائمه حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك المفدى.
Your Lordships, Excellencies, Ladies and Gentlemen, Dear Friends, It is a great pleasure to address you again tonight. And I know I speak on behalf of so many people in Bahrain when I say that we have no greater friends in the United Kingdom than the Bahrain society. The work that you have done in promoting British-Bahraini friendship often goes unmentioned and is sometimes not fully acknowledged. But I want you to know that Bahrain's gratitude for your attachment to our country remains undiminished. You have been by our side when we needed you. You are what real friends should be with us in both sunshine and rain. I should have said dust. But I mean the dust of a tank and the dust of armored vehicles during the Gulf War. But when the hand of conciliation extended by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince was not taken, the intention of those we were dealing with was clear. We had to intervene. For the sake of our nation and for the sake of the overwhelming majority who wanted nothing to do with violent extremists. We had to contain the situation. We did not want to reach a position where innocent people, Sunnis, Shia, and other groups were confronting each other on our streets. We wanted to avoid sectarian conflict and casualties. Actually, we wanted to protect the people and save the country. I am pleased that at the end, our restraint and our discipline prevailed. Today, Bahrain is coming out of that period of its history stronger than before. The country is stable and now open for businesses. Those who unleashed violence on our country in 2011 clearly wanted to derail our path of reform. But we have not allowed them to achieve their objective. Far from retreating from our reforms, we have carried on. Let me be very clear. We are against violations of human rights, not only because they are against our law, but also because they are against everything we stand for as a decent, educated Bahraini Muslim society. So there is not and will never be a culture of impunity in Bahrain. In contrast, constructive chaos of 2011 that I described earlier, recent years have seen a change in the threat to a more organized terrorism. We have intercepted military-grade weapons shipments from Iran, including C4 explosives, and found weapons made in Iran. We still face a propaganda war from Iranian-backed media organizations. We continue to see London being used as an external base for terrorist activities and incitement in Bahrain. But we need to tackle hatred. National pride must come before division. We need to maintain social harmony between all Bahrainis. And we need to address the worrying trend of children being used by extremists and of young people being influenced negatively through social media. I am deeply concerned with how to protect our youth, both from extremism and political violence, and from crime in general, including the use of drugs. Extremism is, of course, a growing threat to all of us, not just young people. Whether it is religious extremism, which hijacks our faith for political ends, or ideological extremism, which wants to overturn the established political order, there is no doubt that extremism is the root of today's terrorism. We don't need a crystal ball to see that the threats facing Bahrain today could very likely face other countries tomorrow. In today's integrated world, there is less room than ever for one man's terrorist genuinely to be another man's freedom fighter. And as we come to the terms with the terrible recent events in Paris, we need all of us to have a very clear idea of how we address and solve the problem of terrorism. In Bahrain, we are convinced that the evil of terrorism can only be overcome through a truly united international action that addresses all aspects of the threat, including its security, financial, social, and media dimension. Action which recognizes the urgency of the situation and which disrupts and prevents terrorist attacks at the earliest possible stage. Dear friends, with that, thank you very much for listening. I wish you a pleasant evening and look forward to many more constructive exchange between us. Shukran.